Carol Ettinger was kind of a rugged guy. You gave him some space, and I loved to watch him because he had something not too many hockey players had. The old head was going every which way, and he could throw a deke, and not quite as high a scorer as Carl, but he was always right up there in the scoring. And then, of course, Ivan was a real good defenseman. I think the Ettingers, what stand out, they were all great skaters, all three of them really good skaters. Very smooth, and certainly hockey players that could have played a lot higher caliber.
The Ettingers could have played in any semi-pro league or anything else like that. There's no question. You know, they were terrific hockey players. You know, Harold was so tricky with the puck, so good playmaker, and Carl had a terrific shot off the left wing. Harold would give him the puck, and he could pick that top corner 9 times out of 10, and you just couldn't believe it. You know.
Ivan was a real good defenseman, there's no doubt about that. He was the choice of several of the teams to play defense. He was one of the fastest skaters they had, and as a defenseman he could skate as fast backwards as he could frontwards. So.
He was some defenseman, that Ivan. You get by him, he'd get shovels behind out and hit you. You couldn't get by him.
You have to remember, a lot of hockey players went out of the Truro District Hockey League, were scouted. Guys like Johnny Mentis, Donnie Dennis, they went away in tryouts, John Matheson. And those were the days of 6 NHL teams. So it was quite a thing to play in the Truro District Hockey League as a young fella, and my friends, to try to play in the District Hockey League was a big goal. And when we finally got there, you know, it was like playing in the NHL to us.
Thing is, it was the best league in town. It was the only thing in town. Your cousin, or your uncle, or your sister, or whatever was going to all the hockey games. And it was a night on a Saturday night. There was 3 games being played and 3 different districts being played. But a lot of people went through the Truro District Hockey League. And the thing is, there were some pretty good hockey players.
I know I was at every game, for what that's worth. And I have fond memories of the crowds that were there and how much the community all fell in line. We would pack the rink before anybody else because we had to look after our boys. It's the way Shabanakity had with the Ettingers as far as sportsmen were concerned.
Brookfield had a pretty poor team, we'll say, but they supported it well. So in 1948-49, they said, okay, Brookfield can go south, and we heard about the Ettingers, and oh boy, they're gonna help us big. So they agreed to come up to Brookfield. We had to come down and get them because they didn't have a car then. So we had to drive down to Shabanakity to get them, and that was Harold and Carl, and we picked up Bert Phillips from Stewiak and take them to the game and then have to drive them to Shabanakity after. But Les, that's their father, was very generous, and their mother used to give us coffee or tea or whatever. But we did that for 2 solid years, you know. And of course, Brookfield won in 1949, the first year we had it, thanks mainly to the 2 Ettingers.
You think of a franchise of those 3 guys. You think of the Hull brothers playing the NHL, or the Richard brothers and things like that. That's what you related to. Those guys were the players on that team.
And the Bears and all that. They won the Nova Scotia Intermediate A Championship in 1947.
There was 5 Bears, so it was the 2 families that really made that team, and then of course they had Alan Milne, one of the best third basemen you could find, and Mark Anthony was a shortstop, and when Harold and Carol wasn't pitching, they'd either play second base or play in the outfield. And then Ivan played in the outfield too. But that was that good team. And in the game that they won the championship, I was there, and there was a ball hit out to left field, and Willis Barr was playing left field, and at that time they didn't wear gloves. only the pitcher, catcher, and first baseman. And Willis, it was up over his head, and he reached up, and it hit the palm of his hand, went up, and he caught it before it came down. And they went on to win that game and the championship.
They meant so much to every young fellow that was around us, and not only right here in Shubenacadie, but Brookfield. Brookfield never loved us from Shubenacadie, but Brookfield always respected the Ettingers.
I really appreciated them, you know, and they paid for us and then against us, and how things happen. We had a big fight with the Ettingers and the Hendersons one night. Some of us were suspended and so on like that. This was in the playoffs, and we eventually beat them in the fifth, and it was 3-5 on an overtime goal.
And we went into sudden death overtime in the fifth and final game. And I was playing 3:00 in the morning yet. We started at 7:30. Had 87 shots on me that night, and they beat us 7-6 in overtime, sudden death. After that big game we had, went into overtime, I said, "Now a good beer tastes good, wouldn't it, hair on Carol?" "It sure would," he said, "and I'm going to have one shortly afterwards."
I was younger than they were, a lot younger. And I didn't chum around with them, but I played a couple games with them on the All-Star team playing against Halifax. And when they come in the dressing room, you're kind of younger and you kind of respect these guys, right? And they had that about them, the air about them. They walk in and they weren't show people. They weren't aggressive people by talking over above anybody else. They would come in, they just did their job.
Carl was, really a super guy that liked to win, and he made no bones about it. He wanted to win, and he'd do whatever was necessary from a smooth way to be a winner.
Easily the best fighter I've ever seen on the ice. Now, not that I'm pushing for fighting in hockey, it has to be, but I mean, Harold kept you honest, there's no question, and which is good, you know.
Nobody fought with Carl or Hyven without Harold getting involved in some way or another, and you had to pay for what you did as far as Harold was concerned.
Carl, I think I won the scoring race in second year before the rink burnt down, and Carl's name was on the trophy at least four times, I believe, and actually should have been named after him. We lost the trophy eventually, but it should have been given to him, actually.
I remember he was in line for the scoring title, and he had two games left to beat Ron McCormick, and the end of the first period, North River was leading Sherby 1-0. By the end of the second period, Sherby is leading 5-1, and Carl had scored 3 goals and had an assist, and that cinched the title for him. And that was one of the highlights of me watching hockey, was to see him win that in that manner.
And I was 12 years old and traveling with them and everything else like that, and looking after their sticks and all this. Well, I didn't have any other big heroes except Harold and Carl Ettinger, you know. I couldn't believe it, you know, and here I was traveling with them all the time and telling stories on the way to and from Shubenacadie. Just imagine, I just said, oh, this is what I want to be. I want to be a hockey player, so.
I remember the last reunion we had a video taken of the last reunion in 92, and again, the picture, of Ivan coming in into the room, and all of Amelia was in there, and Ivan had the big Shubenacadie sweater, and he was some proud of it. He just walked across the room holding this big Shubenacadie sweater up, and it was pretty neat, I thought, you know.
Well, I want them people to know that they're wonderful boys. Oh, they're great athletes, and they're great hockey players, and great to mix with.
You knew them for anything that was sport. You could go there and buy your bats and balls, or you could go there and get your hockey skates. And that was their business. And they were always, I know I bought my first bat and ball there that I remember, but I remember Carl coming up and showing me how this bat was better than these others, and this meant a lot to me as a kid.
They were good community people, you know, and I think they deserve to be in the Hall of Fame, and I most certainly would vote for them.
Carl Ettinger, Harold Ettinger, and Ivan Ettinger are so deserving to be going into your East Hants Sports Hall of Fame. Tremendous, tremendous athletes and great hockey players. Very deserving.
2015 East Hants Sport Hall of Fame inductee, Harold, Carl, and Ivan, the Ettinger brothers.